Assalamualaikum and a very good morning. So today we'll continue back our lecture for rubber processing. Previously, you guys already learned about some equipments to process rubber, such as the two raw mills and the new concept of two raw mills. And for today, we will learn about new equipments, okay, to process the rubber. Okay. Today, I will introduce you guys to a new equipment to process rubber, which is the internal mixing machine. Okay, first of all, let's have a look at the internal mixing machine. For the internal mixing machine, okay, first we have the ram, we have the hopper, we have the cooling channels, we have the rotor. This is the rotor, okay, and then we have the discharge door, and then this is the casing to protect the rubber compound. Okay, so the roller of a mill are twisted to produce a corkscrew effect. This is the function of the rotor, to produce a corkscrew effect. And a block of steel is placed over the mill nibs with the block connected to a steel above it. This is what we call as the ram. So this is the force that will be applied to push the raw rubber or the compound inside the chamber so that the rotor can squeeze or shear the rubber to be processed. And then the ram will move up to allow addition of ingredients to the nib, and it will move down to force the compound ingredients into the nib. So when you want to put ingredients, okay, you will put the ingredients through the hoppers. Okay, so during the addition of the ingredients, the ram need to be pushed up so that the ingredient can be put inside and later transfer into the chamber. Once the transfer or the addition of the ingredients are complete, then the ram need to push back down so that it will close this chamber. The whole thing is surrounded by a heavy metal jacket with a shutter at the top to put ingredients in and a door at the bottom. This is what we call as the discharge door to let out the material or the rubber compound. In 1960, Mr. Friendly H. Banbury improved on an internal mixing machine built by Werner and Fliederer by designing the Banbury machine. The internal mixer rapidly became an essential part of the rubber industry. At the present time, mixers are available in sizes ranging from those capable of mixing a kilogram or so to those can mix more than 500 grams. Okay, so the mixer range, okay, from a very small compound, which is a kilo, until a very large compound, which is around 500 kilo per load, equivalent to many large mills. The internal mixer is faster, and then it is more cleaner, which produces less dust from powdery materials such as carbon black, silica, and clay. This is what, okay, happen when we use the two raw mill. Okay, as we previously discussed, when using two raw mill, it will create an environmental issue as well as a health hazard, whereas the dust from the powdery ingredients started to float into the air. Okay, and then using the internal mixer also uses less floor space and is probably less operator sensitive, by means that you only need to dump all the ingredients and weight it based on the parameter output of the machine. Unless when you use a two raw mill, okay, it's more depending on the operator because it is an open equipment where the operator need to be careful and need to observe the compound to determine whether it is homogeneous and or else the ingredients have been distributed very well inside the compound. Thus, internal mixer displaces the mill for most compounding operation, Why? Because of the effectiveness of the machine as well as the enclosure, which will not create an environmental issue as well as the safety of the operator. However, the variable nib opening of a meal plus immediate visual feedback of the state of the mix allow a good meal operator a high degree of control and consequently dispersion. Okay, this is what we talk about, the advantages of using a two raw meal, which cannot be obtained by using the internal mixer. Okay, when you use an internal mixer, this is an enclosure equipment. Okay, so when it's an enclosed equipment, so the operator cannot see or observe what is happening inside the chamber. And it's only depending on the output parameters such as the temperature, the electrical watt, okay, and then the sound. But however, when we are using the two raw meals, the operator can have a direct visual feedback of the state of the mixing because this is an open chamber. The internal mixer has a fast mixing capability from around 2 to 10. Okay, so we can see that it's around 2 to 10 minutes and does require an efficient cooling. Okay, because of the very fast processing of the rubber, by means that it produces much more heat, and then it also an enclosed equipment, so the heat build up are starting to accumulate inside the chamber. Thus, it requires a very efficient cooling system, as we know that heat is a very crucial element toward rubber processing. This is provided by drill channels into the wall of the mixing chamber. So when you see the chamber, okay, so it have a drill channel, okay. So these holes, okay, the function of these holes around the channel is to distribute the heat outside the chamber or as a cooling system. And then the rotors and the discharge door can also be water cooled. The temperature of the compound being mixed is measured by a thermocouple in the side of the mixing chamber. So the thermocouple function as a parameter or the output parameter to see what is the temperature inside the compound. Other parameters which can be measured and controlled during the mixing process are the electrical power and the time. Okay, and then there are two sizes of internal mixer. First is the number 11 Bamberry mixer, which can contribute to the minimum of 180 kg until to the 250 kg per mix. And the number 27 Bamberry mixer, which is a larger equipment or larger internal mixer, okay, which can accumulate up to 500 kg of a mixed rubber compound. Okay, basically, a large mixer can occupy up to 3 floors, okay, whereas the ground floor are usually the discharge door. The middle floor are the hopper and the chamber, and then the top floor are the ramps. Okay, this is the conceptual cross-section throughout an internal mixer. So this is the ramp, and then the function of the ramp is to press down, okay, all the ingredients and the raw rubber inside the chamber. And then this is the hopper where you insert your ingredients and raw rubber. Okay, and then this is the chamber wall, and there are drill holes, okay, at the chamber wall. This is the function to let the heat, okay, that are built up inside the chamber to distribute out of the chamber or act as a cooling system. And then this is the rotor, and then this is the discharge door. Okay, so the compound can be taken out using this discharge door. Okay, this one. Thank you. Okay, so we continue to our lecture. Okay, so this is the sequence. Okay, this is a sequence of using the internal mixer. First, the raw gum in the stomach is dropped through the hopper into the mixing chamber where it is mixed by the rotors. And then the RAM, okay, and then the RAM. And then the RAM pressed onto the rubber mixture is forced down by a pneumatically or hydraulically controlled cylinder whose pressure is adjusted to give the best control of the mixing. So this is the function of the RAM, which will press down the rubber, raw rubber, or the raw rubber mixture inside the chamber. And then oil may be poured from the hopper or injected through a valve in the hopper wall just above the mixing chamber. And then what is the function of the oil? The oil acts as a processing aid. Processing aid, okay, to help the mixing of the rubber mixture. The mixed rubber can be discharged from the machine either by rotation of the whole mixing chamber or through a discharge door at the bottom of the mixing, depending on the mixing design. Okay, and then the mixing can occur between the rotor. Okay, so as you guys need to know that mixing inside the internal mixer, there are two types. First are between the rotors. Okay, this is the rotor. So this mixing is between the rotor. Another one is mixing between the rotor and the wall chamber. Let's say this is your compound. Okay, mixing can occur between the rotor. This is what we call as the intermeshing rotors, or between the mixing walls and the rotor. This is what we call as the tangential rotor, depending on the mixing. Mixing can occur between the rotor, intermeshing rotor, or between the mixing chamber wall and the rotors. This is called as the tangential rotor, depending on the mixing. To the rotor to rotor or rotor to the wall, clearance is very important to correct the mixing. Okay, so the clearance means that the distance between the rotor and rotor, or the rotor and the wall, are very important in determining the quality of the mixture, rubber mixture. And then this is the recent modification, the Banbury S3 rotors, okay, synchronous technology and Pomini Wicks variable intermeshing clearance design, where the distance between the rotor can be varied. Okay, basically, okay, the rotor, let's say this is the rotor, okay, the distance between the rotor are controlled or the same, okay, basically, but in the new modification, this distance can be varied, okay, where it can be changed or different depending on what type of mixing we are trying to accomplish. Rotor design have recently been subject of much research using finite element analysis technique, okay, and then the design of the rotor itself also will determine the quality of the mixture. Okay, this is the internal mixing machine processing. Okay, the mixing principles are similar to those of the two raw mills. First, the raw gum elastomer is dropped into the hopper and the RAM allowed to move down under pressure. And then the RAM is raised for each addition of materials or as ingredients and then lowered to compact the mixture in the mixing chamber. When the rotors in the mixing chamber have masticated the rubber compound, so it achieves a coherent mass, small quantity materials such as antioxidants, zinc oxide, and stearic acid may be added. Okay, and then how does an operator control the internal mixer? Basically, okay, the internal mixer are being controlled based on the temperature, rotor speed, dwell time, and the RAM pressure. This is the internal mixing machine for natural rubber. For natural rubber, the time taken to achieve coherence can be somewhat long due to its high viscosity, which need to be reduced by mastication. So the mastication process will lower the viscosity of the natural rubber before ingredients can be added inside the compound. This involves a separate step where the mixer is exclusively and completely filled with natural rubber gum elastomer, which is worked to reduce its elasticity and increase its plasticity. It's then dumped from the mixer. After resting, a portion of it returned to the mix with other compounding ingredients. So basically, when we use internal mixer to mix, okay, or to process the natural rubber compound, first we need to masticate the rubber. Okay, so internal mixer also can masticate the rubber, and the mastication is done without adding any other ingredients. Okay, so the internal mixer will shear the natural rubber until it will have a lower viscosity. Okay, once the mastication is complete, the natural rubber is dumped out from the internal mixer to let it rest or cool down. Later, the rested, okay, natural rubber again being introduced or add into the hopper, followed by the ingredients, okay, to compound the natural rubber. Internal mixing machine additive. Filler are then added. Large total amount can be added incrementally and after most of the filler have been mixed in. Any oil in the formulation may be added to be introduced. If oil addition is delayed too long, the filler become totally encapsulated by the elastomer. So, let's say you have your rubber, okay, and then the use of oils is as a processing aid to help process the mixture of the rubber compound. If you add your oil, okay, in a very long time or delay too long, okay, the filler itself started to accumulate, okay, inside the rubber itself. Okay, the oil addition, especially larger quantities, can cause a loss of shearing action, resulting in slippery mess in the mixing chamber. But if you add too much oil, okay, the shearing of the rubber cannot be occurred. And then this is what we call as the slippery of the compound, where there is no shear, okay, occur inside the chamber. Okay, and then this is the feedback, okay, from the internal mixing machine, okay, where the operator can have early indication of what is happening inside the chamber. First is the sound of the electrical motor. Second is the electrical power usage indicator, the temperature gauge, the time clock, and the sucking sound of the batch. Okay, so the sound itself, okay, the sound itself, the noise of increased power from the motor is a happy sound for compound with high level of oil addition because it indicates that the mixing is finally occurring. So when you have your internal mixer and you are doing your compounding, okay, and then it started to make a very rough and loud sound. So this is an indication for the operator to say that the compound inside the chamber are starting to be shed. Okay, and then the temperature. Often, a particular temperature is chosen at which to complete the mixing process and dump the batch. Okay, it's depending on the rubber material itself. Okay, let's say you are using some type of rubber, and then the maximum temperature, okay, for the rubber because it started to vulcanize is around 100. So when you see the temperature gauge and then the temperature is around 100, as an operator, you need to stop and dump the rubber before proceed to put another ingredients. And then the total time to mix the batch should correlate with the temperature. Basically, longer time will create a higher temp preacher. Okay, and then let's go back to our, okay, this is the power, electrical power usage indicator. Okay, so basically when you use an electrical power usage indicator, so when the indicator show that the electrical power consumption is very high, by means that there are shearing inside the internal mixer chamber, and then the sucking sound of the batch, okay, if there are sound produced inside the chamber, like a sucking sound, by means that the shear of the rubber inside the chamber also started to occur. Okay, and then the internal mixing machine encounters, compounded with large quantity of reinforcing filler, can often reach temperatures over 150 degrees by the time they are mixed. So they will therefore be dumped from the mixer, often without sulfur and definitely without any accelerator. This is what we call as the master batch. Okay, without adding any accelerator and sulfur. The master batch will be cooled pure to being returned to the mixer for addition of this material. So after the master batch is cooled, then it will introduce back into the internal mixing, and then sulfur and accelerator will be added. For compounds with a very high filler, such as a very high clay loading, the RAM may plug through the clay like quicksand. By means that if you are using a very high filler, okay, when the RAM started to go down, okay, and force are being applied, the RAM are not pushing the filler inside the chamber, but the RAM are being pushed inside the filler like a quicksand. So early addition of oil is one solution, and then the idea being to bind the filler into particles, thus increasing the coherence and encouraging the shear. Okay, this is what called as a glimpse of the arts and technology of compound mixing, where the internal mixing machine strive to break down the size of solid ingredients, dispersive mixing, and distribute the particles evenly throughout the mixing, distributive mixing. So by means that, okay, when we are processing a rubber, it is more like an art, okay, seni. Okay, so how we are going to process a rubber, and what is the indicator or parameters that we need to look out to control the mixing of the rubber to achieve a very high quality of rubber mixing. Okay, this is the comparison between the two raw mills and the internal mixer. Basically, when a two raw mill is being used, the number of operator are lower compared to the internal mixer. Okay, and then the sizes of a internal mixer, okay, are larger compared to the two raw mills, and then shorter time are required to process the rubber using internal mixer compared to the two raw mills, and then the production rate per kg is higher by using an internal mixer compared to the two raw mill. Okay, this is the main feature of mills and internal mixer machine. Okay, two raw mills. Okay, this is the advantages of using a two raw mill. First, it is an open to atmosphere, health and environment hazard. Okay, sorry, this is not the advantages. What is the difference between using internal mixer compared to two raw mill? First, two raw mill, as we all know, is an open chamber. So open to the atmosphere, health and hazard, environmental hazard, whereas the internal mixer is an enclosed chamber and not hazardous. Okay, not suitable for mixing small particle fillers. Okay, and then internal mixer are very suitable for small particle fillers such as carbon, very dependent on skill of operator, less dependent on operator skill, suitable for small badges, suitable for larger badges. Okay, long time requires, okay, this is, but internal mixer require a shorter time. Lower production rate, okay, this is internal mixer, we produce a higher production rate. Lower operating cost, however, using internal mixer, have a very high operating cost as well as high capital cost. Okay, whereas the Turomi have a very low capital cost. Okay, this is a modification of internal mixer. It's what we call as the continuous internal mixer. Okay. The benefit of mixing rubber compound continuously rather than via a batch process include the potential to improve statistical process control because of the development of a steady state and improved possibility for automation. The first attempts to develop a continuous mixer for rubber date back to the 1950s, following many years of reliance on the Banbury internal mixer. This led to the introduction of Farrell continuous mixer in the year of 1960. Okay, this is the Farrell continuous mixer. Okay, this is the feed or hopper where you put all your material. This is the screw. It will work as continuously. Okay, this is the mixing chamber. And then this is the discharge orifice gate where the material can be dumped out. So this works as a continuous mixing. Okay, as long as you put your material, it will start to mix as time, and then it will start to is where is the rubber compound being dumped. Okay, the advantage of using continuous mixer, okay, the mixing is continuously. Okay, and then as long as you put the material, it will start to mix. Okay, and then once the mixing is complete, it started, it will then will taken out. Okay. Okay, continuous mixer operation. The continuous mixer carry out the unit operation of mixing, incorporation, distribution, dispersion, and viscosity reduction. So this is all carried out continuously. Okay, so what is the difference between dispersion and distributive? Okay, the reduction in size of particles agglomerate is achieved when the compound pass through the high shear zone, okay, between the rotor tip and the chamber wall. Okay, this is the reduction of size of particles agglomerates. The greater the number of times compound passes through this zone, the higher level of dispersion. Distributive mixing takes place in the area between the rotors. This is between the rotor and the rotor. In the rolling bank of compound, a head of the nib formed by the rotor tip and the chamber and form the back pumping cost by the reverse helix rotor zone. Okay, this is the high shear between the rotor and the chamber. Okay, this is what we call as dispersion. Okay, this is the distributive. Okay, this occur between the rotor and the rotor. Okay, and then the continuous mixer variables. Okay, four variables control the operation. First is the operation rate. Second is the rotor speed. Third is the discharge orifice. Last is the mixing chamber temperature. This is the variables which control the operation of continuous mixer. Okay, so as the rotor speed increase, okay, the horsepower will also increase, and then the temperature inside will also increase. At a given feed rate, and therefore residence time, increased rotor speed increase the extent both of the distributive, okay, as well as a dispersive mixing, but this is at the expense of increased energy input, as with batch mixing, as has the consequence of higher exit temperature. And then this is the effect of discharge orifice, as the exit opening made smaller at a given speed rate and rotor speed, power draws and stop temperature increase. So when the orifice opening are greater, okay, so it's larger, but means that, okay, the horsepower are lower and then the temperature are lower. Okay, this is the effect of production rate and chamber temperature. So as the production rate increase, okay, the temperature will also increase. Okay, chamber temperature affect the coefficient of the friction of the compound, influencing incorporation and distribution as well as reduction of compound viscosity. Okay, and then let's recap what is the benefit of internal mixer. First, it accepts almost any trade form. It's a proven technology. No need for special dosing equipment. Both automatic and manual control. Efficient dispersion effects. Flexibility in run length. Easy to maintain and robust machine. Wide application field. However, the disadvantages of internal mixer is that it's high power peak, batch-to-batch variation, heat history, material weight variation, dust forming by air movement, labor intensive, okay, many adjustable parameters, high installation cost, complicated downstream. Okay, the benefit of continuous internal mixer, steady power supply, fine-tuning possible, labor extensive, constant high degree of mixing, lower erection cost, higher degree of dispersion because of lack of dead spots, direct extrusion possible, direct clandering possible. And then the disadvantages of continuous mixer is that the free flowing of materials, developing technology, complicated dosing machine necessary, automatic control only, beneficial for long run only, high mass temperature, screw optimization for one compound. Okay, I think that's all for our class for rubber processing. Okay, for next part, okay, it will be continued by Encik Azrin. Thank you and Assalamualaikum.